What's up, y'all? Filthy Glamour checking in. And I know I've been gone for a minute. Now it's time to bring it back. But if y'all want to see how I got these cute hearts on this little wig, y'all stay tuned and click the subscribe button while y'all here. All right, so we're wasting no time. We're gonna get right into it. This look was inspired by The Real Judy Moody on TikTok. I'm gonna pause and post her video right now.
Like for part two.
So that was the inspiration, and as you can see, I just picked an old wig that was short, and I figured it would be perfect for this tutorial. I started off by washing her, blow drying her, and getting her flat iron. Now, I did say that I'm going to mention what I could have, would have, should have done, and the first thing that I should have done was customize that part, get it customized. Meaning pluck it, conceal it, the whole nine to get it perfect to my liking. But once you're done flat ironing and customizing your part, what you would want to do is take your Gatsby or whatever aerosol holding spray you're using, and what you want to do is spray your hair until it gets firm and as flat as possible. What another thing I should have done was immediately after I sprayed it the first time, I should have combed it as flat as possible to smooth out all those lumps and pumps. But once you feel like you have a firm foundation, now we're ready to paint. Now, I did this look using acrylic paints from Walmart. I also purchased the brushes from Walmart too. So I started with a smaller brush and did like a small outline of a heart just to get the feel of it. And I must say, this was harder than what it looked like. I had to go back in with my holding spray because the hair was a little shaky. I wasn't confident, but I'm like, we must see it through, my girl. So at this point, I'm just doing hearts, traces of hearts around the head, just so I can get an accurate depiction of where I want the heart placement, etc., etc. And as you can see, this was a task for me. Like, they need to send me back to kindergarten, third grade, back to where we were drawing shapes, because it was way harder than what it was given on the TikTok video. But you know, we just gotta keep on pressing. So that's what we did. I think in total I did about maybe 10 hearts. And look at that, just horrible, Lord. But he was with me, and it gets greater later. Y'all just stay tuned. Like, y'all don't know how bad I wanted to give up in the middle of this, but I'm like, you know, we got to see it through. So while you all are watching, I'm just gonna take the time and give you all some tips and pointers that could potentially help you if you do decide to do the same thing. For starters, most of the paint that I have seen done on here usually happens with a middle part. As you can see, I have a side part, it's a bob, like asymmetrical bob, it's giving graduation in the back. So it was a lot of factors that had a lot to do with this. Going forward, I would like to make it easy on myself and do perhaps the middle part. The lady in the TikTok also used a different brand of acrylic paint. Both of them were acrylic paints nonetheless, but she did use a different brand. It was that brand that they used to use in the nail shops back in the early 2000s. So that might be the better brand. So I would like to try that next go around. Yeah, I was doing too much in there. I wanted a variety of colors. I bought neon acrylic paint. I was just doing too much, and I should have just stuck to the code. So yeah, going forward, if I could do this again, I would probably do a middle part, as well as the acrylic paint that the lady in the TikTok used. Yeah, I also would have, like I said, after the first time I sprayed it with the holding spray, the aerosol spray, I would have combed out all of those kinks like the girl in the video. Now, it didn't turn out horrible per se, but I just feel like there are things I could have done better to achieve better results. So like I said, I did all of this in one night. I probably did 2 to 3 coats each heart, just doing an outline, then trying to perfect it, and then trying to make the lines bold per se. So yeah, I probably did 2 to 3 coats that night. I do kind of project hand painted hair to be maybe a fad this summer. I did see Cardi B in the Shake It video with like a bandana hand painted thing going on. So don't say I didn't tell you first. So like I told you all, this is like the first go round, just painting hearts, filling in spaces, just making it look good. Together doing drawing the initial parts that night took maybe about an hour and a half at the most. Yeah, so at this point I figured I did enough hearts. I was tired, I was sick and tired of my own self and these hearts. So next morning we got back to it, as you can see, and then I decided that I wanted to go in with a little bit of color this time. So I did go in with my light pink as well as my neon pink. And when I started with the light pink, I instantly regretted it. Like, maybe I should have kept these hearts white. And I'm not trying to be discouraging, but you know, when you're trying something new, it's just like, oh my God, I hope it turns out right. And it's like, you really don't have the time to be playing. And yeah, so at this point, I'm just going in with color, with the colors pink, darker pink, neon, and red, and just coloring some of those hearts just to give it a little dimension. And I also did go over some of the hearts that I left white with white. Now I did leave a vast majority of the hearts white because it just pops on the hair, and I did feel like the pink and the red is kind of toning it down, taking away from its pop. So at this point, once you have the foundation laid with the hearts, what you want to do is keep applying coats to make it more vibrant, make it more firm and more of a steady foundation. Another reason I say I would much rather do a middle part next go around, because as you can see, the bang, It has to flow. I don't want no stiff bang, and that was just me. So I had to be very gentle when I got towards the bang area, which also explains why she doesn't have any hearts like right there on the flowing piece. Also, another disclaimer, with this wig, I typically do like the swoop look with it, so that kind of explains why the asymmetrical is just like really giving Grandma Sherry in the bang part. And I also got some pants from Shein. How you say it? Shein? No, I just like to say it like that. But yeah, I also got some pants from Shein, and they have these hearts on them too, and the hearts on there don't look too cute either. So either way it goes, it's still going to be a hit, because I got some pants to match with it. It's going to create a whole look. And if you want to see the look, follow me on TikTok at Filthy Glamour the brand, or Filthy Glamour, either one, it doesn't matter. So at this point, you just want to keep going in with these colors, keep laying coats, making it brighter, because every coat just makes it pop a little bit more. Alright, now, so at this point, I'm going to head out. If you want to see how I dress this wig up with my Shein pants, follow me on TikTok once again at Filthy Glamour or Filthy Glamour the brand. And yeah, if you like this video, like, comment, and subscribe. I promise to be a little bit more consistent this go round. And yeah, and another thing, I had used Glow in the Dark paint and that ish did not work. And I also meant to tell you all, when you drawing the hearts, dab, don't drag it. It'll take you a long way. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button once again. And I can't wait to see you all the next go round. I'm just gonna let this play out until the end, and you all get to see how she turns out. Now look at her, y'all. My big bed looking like a bag of money. You see what happens when you see it through? That's why you just stick with it till the end. Then you determine if you don't like it. But yeah, make sure y'all subscribe, and I'll see you all next video.